name is Audrey Rousseau. I am a senior in New York homeschooled, and I am representing Lincoln Southeast High School today. And this is my poem, Little Miss Perfect Afternoon. Every morning I wake up, I scour every inch of my body, notice every imperfection, the way my eyes squint when I smile, the fact that I can't control my hair, and every scar I cause my body turning into me, until there is nothing left but an empty carcass inviting every filthy animal to do as he pleases. To protect myself, I cover every scar. Each is an untold story. I never understood why women choose to silence their stories, but every time his hand sprays my body, I am left asking myself, why me? What did I do as I stand paralyzed? So I continue to slip into the dress that hugs every curve of my body, that clasps so tight it leaves me gasping for air, unable to breathe. I try to scream for help, but nothing escapes my lips. He tells me I am beautiful, therefore I am silent. I put on the shoes, I put on the heels, I can barely stand it. Walking is a battle I lost before I even started, but it really doesn't matter because I was never supposed to go anywhere anyways. Instead, I am supposed to stand frozen, flawless like a mannequin in a store window. It's so perfect for people to ooh and all over. Point out every imperfection, hold my body to their liking, and if they like what they see, then all you can say to their And what they don't know is a night when the store is closed, lights off and prime lights on. I slip out of the dress, kick off the heels, and leap every memory of the day away, tears flowing down my broken bruised body when I look up with a puddle on the floor at my feet. And as I sit staring at my reflection, I realize I am not a mirror with an obscured image of who I am because of your unwanted filthy hands on my body. I am not a model in your magazine for you to post to your perception. And I am not a mannequin in a store window wearing a dress that sounds of me or heels that keep me grounded from the truth. But I am a strong woman who wear my favorite t-shirt and boots to allow me to walk straight up my mountain, letting my voice be heard. It's not my fault. No more of your excuses, no more living your life unaware of the consequences of your actions, and no, it just doesn't happen, it's your choice, and my choice is to fight back. So when I climb back down, you're still going to rule and awe over me, because I am not going to be defined by what you did or didn't do, what I wear or don't wear. I am defined by my story, turn on turn, the pain of my past, the promise of my future. It is me being confident in knowing who I am, and who I am is worthy. So I pick myself up off the floor, boots in hand, smile wide on face, my voice louder than ever before.